Your doctor has told you that you have a hernia, but what does that actually mean? In general terms, we can say that a hernia occurs when the layers that make up the abdominal wall weaken. In other words, the fabric of muscle and other tissues which protect the gut develops a defect or weakness. Through that defect, the peritoneum and perhaps other organs push their way outward, forming a lump which can be felt and sometimes seen protruding from the abdomen. During normal childhood development, boys' testes slowly descend from the interior of the abdomen down into the scrotum. They pass through the abdominal wall by way of a natural passageway called the inguinal canal. In men, the inguinal canal contains blood vessels that supply the testes as well as the vessel that carries sperm to the penis. Hernias that occur due to a weakness in the abdominal wall at the inguinal canal are called inguinal hernias. And not surprisingly, men are 25 times more likely than women to experience a hernia in this area. Some inguinal hernias press directly through the floor of the inguinal canal. Others follow the route taken by the blood vessels that supply the testes. This kind of hernia, called an indirect hernia, can even push all the way into the scrotum. Surgical procedures performed by making an incision large enough to expose the entire operative area are called open procedures. Your doctor believes that your medical condition and overall state of health make you a good candidate for a less intrusive laparoscopic surgery. A laparoscope is a narrow tube that contains a light source and a small video camera. Using a laparoscope, the surgeon is able to operate by making one or more very small incisions through which the sterile laparoscope and possibly other instruments are inserted into the body. Using the laparoscope's video camera, the surgeon is able to explore and inspect the interior of the abdomen, often allowing the surgeon to see with greater detail and with more clarity than with the human eye alone. However, it is important to understand that during the procedure, your surgical team is always prepared to convert a laparoscopic procedure to an open procedure, should they feel that your condition requires a more direct approach. If the surgical team makes this decision, you will find upon waking up that your doctor has made a larger incision and that healing may proceed more slowly. Converting to an open procedure will affect the length of your recovery and will probably require hospitalization. Of course, no surgery is completely risk-free, but your physician believes that if you decide not to undergo the recommended procedure, you may be putting your health at risk. After allowing a few minutes for the anesthetic to take effect, a small incision is made below the umbilicus. Then a hollow needle will be inserted through the abdominal wall, and the abdomen will be inflated with carbon dioxide. An umbilical port is created for the laparoscope. Two or more incisions will be made, with care taken to keep the openings as small as possible. Once in place, the laparoscope will provide video images that allow the surgeon to inspect the hernia and the surrounding tissues. Once the hernia has been located, the surgeon carefully opens the peritoneum in order to reveal the hernia sac. Next, the surgeon carefully draws the hernia sac back into the abdominal cavity. A mesh patch is then inserted over the opening in the peritoneum and is secured in place with surgical staples. This patch reinforces the weakened abdominal wall and helps prevent a second hernia from developing in the same space. Finally, the peritoneum is closed over the mesh, taking care to protect the spermatic cord. All of the instruments are withdrawn. The carbon dioxide is allowed to escape, and the skin is closed with sutures or staples. Finally, a sterile dressing is applied.